What is it? Oh, it's a little, like, you go inside your hair and make it nice?
Yeah, but I want something similar to that, but like not that.
Oh, but what about this? What about this? What about this? Pony poppin' knot. Yeah, that sounds like something you need. What about this? What about this?
Does anybody remember these? From the 90s. I used to put this in my hair and it used to hurt so bad because I had nappy ass hair. It would tuck your head back, your hair back, but it hurt.
It looks like an unnecessary headband. Like it's got spikes on it.
Yeah,
like this would do the same exact
thing. It keeps it like nice and secure, but my neck.
Well, I mean, don't get a tight one of these.
Hair.
Yeah, we gotta go. We're gonna be late. Cause you're still trying to get coffee. Have you ever had one of these bliss out teas? Or the, whatever they are called, I don't know. But I usually get the what's it called? The pineapple green tea or black tea one, and it's usually pretty good. At the condo again, just got back from dropping Tessa off at, well, I don't know where it's at, but it was right next to where the ceremony's gonna be. So I dropped off all the other bridesmaids to get everything ready and set up for today. I dropped off at like 9:15 and the ceremony's not until 4, so I assume they got a lot of work they need to do. I plan on getting outside today for most of the day. I wanna head over to the beach that's only a couple hotels over so I can walk over there from here, and they have a bunch of this might sound lame, they have a bunch of rocks on their beach, and I want to do like the, make a rock tower, like how people stack the rocks like all in crazy formations, like from small or big to small, and make like, see how high they can stack them, because the other day in the vlog I did that, and it's actually pretty fun. It's like a little puzzle, it's a pretty good challenge. So I might go there for a little bit and just hang out, try to get more time in the sun. I might go to the pool, I might get in the water, I'm not quite sure yet. I definitely want to make sure I spend a lot of time outside today because tomorrow will be the last day and I want to spend a lot of time outside tomorrow also so I get a nice little tan going before I get back to the States or the mainland, whatever you want to call it. I still have like a very, very slight farmer's tan, but it's definitely a big difference. Like I haven't like had my shirt off or been tanning in California for like the past 6 months because it's been pretty cold. It just recently got hot like the week before I left, so I'm excited to go back with a nice even tan. So now to get ready for beach season, because my goal is spending time at the beach like every day. I literally go to the beach at least like 4 times a week. You can play spike ball, you can go out there and read, you can get in the water. I want to start doing like beach swim or run workouts, so I want to have a nice even tan when I get there, so I don't look like a bozo with a black arms and white torso. Right now what I need to work on is this stupid Granite Games qualifier video. I put workout 3 up and I knew it might get copyrighted because I had, there was music playing like in the gym. So I was like, oh, it might just have me copyright it and it'll have me block the songs. But I actually blocked the whole video. So I took that down, put up another video. I put a bunch of instrumental songs up like from Drake and Kendrick Lamar and stuff. When I did that, it still got copyrighted and still got blocked. So now I'm taking that video down and I'm gonna post the whole thing again with just me talking in the beginning to state like, Eric Hudson, workout 3, and I'm just gonna cut the audio from there and have it be blank because I think it's the only way I'm gonna be able to get it up without having issues. I really like the Granite Games workouts. They're very open-esque in the sense of it's just like they're short, fast sprint workouts. There hasn't been anything that's been too long yet. They've all had like 14, 12, 8-minute time caps. So I'm interested to see if in the third week is the last week they're gonna have the workout, so it's a total of 2 per week, 6 altogether. I wonder if the last week they'll have like maybe like a 20-minute AMRAP or anything like that, because everything so far has just been with a time cap. Real quick before we head out, I want to show you the 2 shirts I got from Lululemon yesterday. These are the, I forget what they're called. Does it have their name on here? So I just looked at the receipt and they're called the 5-year basic tee. I'm assuming they must last like 5 years or something, I don't know. But I got 2 really simple colors. I got this light gray and I have this dark navy blue color. I already have like a greenish one. It's like a, I don't know what to explain. It's kind of like a mossy, dark mossy green. And then I also have one that's like a little lighter than this. It's like a little bit of off-white. And then it has dark gray stripes going across, like thin pencil stripes. I like it a lot. But the reason I wanted to get a couple more of these shirts is because they are incredibly comfortable. Like I mentioned the other day, they're like a dry fit type material. So it's like really, it's really stretchy. I don't know if you can tell on camera. Yeah, they're really stretchy, but it's like cotton. It's 70% cotton, so it's like, it's lightweight, it feels really durable, they're very comfortable, and they're like soft on your skin. I don't know what it is about these shirts, but I absolutely love them. the only thing about Lululemon is, like, obviously it's nice stuff, so it's gonna be more on the more expensive side. For example, guess how much this shirt was. Say a number. This is how much the shirt was.
$58.
The only reason I can justify buying these shirts is because if you are a trainer, I don't think it's just a CrossFit trainer. I'm pretty sure it's like any, whether you teach Pilates, Zumba, bodybuilding, whatever it is. If you're a trainer and you get registered in the system as a trainer, you get 25% off everything. So I end up paying $43.50 per shirt, so I got $14.50 off, which is still incredibly expensive for a shirt. But they're called the 5-year tees. I'm assuming they're gonna last pretty long, and they're just really comfortable, they're really durable. And I just want some more plain tees that I know are reliable. And when it comes, I'm a very awkward body shape. I'm only 5'5". I've been weighing like 165, so I've been a little heavier as of the past couple months. But I'm very short and stocky, so when it comes to like buying shirts that fit me, it's a big hassle. I almost always have to try them on beforehand. If I buy anything online, half the time it won't fit me. I end up giving it away or returning it, whatever it is. When it comes to buying shirts and shorts, if it fits me nice, I will buy it all the time, because I buy large size shirts, and some larges will like go to my kneecap, so I'm like, okay, can't wear this. And then sometimes if I get a medium, it's super tight and compact, and like I don't have, like it's tighter on my shoulders, it won't fit that way. So it's like, I'm a very awkward, stubby, short guy, so if I don't have something that fits me nicely, I hate it. So these shirts are absolutely amazing. I love them. Otherwise, I wouldn't justify buying anything else from there. I've bought in one pair of shorts before, because supposedly it's supposed to be amazing. They can shorten them, you can return them and exchange them if you ever, you know, get skinnier or fatter, or you want to, whatever, you can always swap them back out. It's like, oh, I'll give it a shot. But then I got them, and I didn't get the one with the inside liners, even though I typically wear compression shorts underneath. I just got the plain, regular shorts that seem pretty big and like spacious for my legs, but every time I would do one squat, they would like go from right above my knee to like a thong, because they would just get stuck on top of my quads. So those didn't work out, and I think I ended up giving those to Goodwill. I can't remember what I did with them, which I probably could have sold on OfferUp for $10. I think I tried, but no one ended up buying them, so I gave them away to Goodwill because I wasn't gonna wear them. But you get what you pay for. So that's my justification for buying these shirts. I normally don't splurge on things like this. The only other thing I've been buying lately for apparel is like Misfit Athletics gear, but that's every like a few months I'll buy like a shirt or a short or something that they end up dropping. But this is like my, I can wear this, you know, going out on a date. I can wear this just around town. I could probably even work out in these shirts if I wanted to, because they're so comfortable and breathable, and like they're still that athletic-y type material to where I could do almost anything in them and not feel restricted. Or like some shirts are really heavy cotton and it feels like it's kind of like crunchy and like really thick. These shirts are not that. So that's my two cents on Lululemon and workout apparel. I like the shirts, they're cool. All right, time to the beach. Today's not as hot as it was yesterday. Yesterday was scorching, but maybe that'll actually change once I get on the sand, because I feel like the sand's always a little warmer like turf and it'll heat you up. But it feels really nice today. It's a little breezy, but it's not bad. It's like cool. But one thing, today is day number like 5 or 6 with this towel, and it hasn't been washed yet, and it smells so bad. Okay, here it is. I don't see anyone stacking rocks now. You can see a couple towers that people like already did, but let's go head down there. All right, quick update. It's the next day. Yesterday at the wedding, I didn't really vlog much, essentially anything. I recorded them walking up. It was a good time overall, but now it's the next day. It's 9:30 in the morning. We're headed to the gym to meet the trainer, Eric, because he's gonna open up the gym for us. So I guess it's closed right now, but he has to make it to a wedding. So we're kind of in a hurry to get there. I'm gonna warm up real quick, stretch real quick, and just hit the workout. I wanna say it's doable to do sub-5. So that's my goal, is to go sub-5 or at least sub-6. All right, we just got here, but Eric actually didn't have to meet us here. He gave us the entry code to get in, because essentially they say they're a 24-hour open gym, and I'm assuming that's what must be what it means, or that's what Tessa pointed out, that they probably just gave all the members the code to get in whenever they want. And since now they have cameras up everywhere, I mean, you know, they can always keep track of who's coming in or what's happening. So we have the whole gym to ourselves right now. So I guess I'll give you guys a real quick tour before I start warming up, since I have a little more time than I thought I would. All right, so boom. You walk in, they have a little, like, they actually have their own supplements, which is pretty cool, their own block supplements. So that's actually a really cool idea. They have some shirts, maybe I'll try to look at them and buy one, see if I can buy one. The iPad's right there. So maybe I'll try to go in there and see if I can buy a shirt. Nice little entranceway. A whole bunch of kettlebells. I have not seen as many kettlebells in a gym ever. Nice little turf strip. So a small set of dumbbells here. They have way more, I'm about to show you in a second. But bands, battle ropes, they have some rowers. They have a couple of assault, so four assault bikes. Four assault bikes. Two air runners, but it's by Woodway. I've never heard of them, but I mean, that's dope. Some TRXs, a bunch of weight plates over there. Then there's their other huge stack of dumbbells. They have a huge variety, all the way up to hundreds. 195, 90s. They have almost every weight going up from, what is, 10 to 100. That's pretty dope. A couple of benches scattered around, a couple plyo boxes, even more benches over here with the incline bench, which is pretty dope. Two nice little platforms, one with a rig. So a whole bunch of change plates over there, but some nice Olympic lifting style plates here. And a little, I don't know what this is called, but the typical thing you would see at a, like, Globo gym, like, thing people do, like, lat pull downs on and that kind of stuff, so that's cool. Here there's sleds for the turf, obviously, and even more battle ropes. But this place is super tiny, so I'm gonna stand over here. It's not that big. It's not that, it's a really long space. I mean, it's enough space to have small, you know, 10-person group classes, but from the pictures I've seen on their Instagram, they have pretty big classes going on. I know they have like a couple early in the day, a couple late night, maybe one middle of the day. Actually, I don't think so. I think it's just a couple early morning, a couple midday, or a couple afternoon. And then the rest of the day is just open gym stuff. So, I don't know, it's a really sweet gym. I like it. Sub 5 or sub 6, yeah, right. My time was 7:11. I thought building up, I was keeping an awesome pace, so I think I probably was like 3:69. Those were all unbroken. Burpees were slower because I figured, okay, I'm gonna sprint burpees on the way back down. Got to the round of 12. I was debating when I first took the bar if I was gonna do all 12. I did, and then once I did like 2 or 3 reps, I was like, okay, I'm gonna do 7, then 5. I ended up dropping at 6. Did another 6, finished out. The 12 burpees were really slow. On the 9s, I did 5 and 4. 9 burpees were really slow, and I was like, all right, I have to pick it up here. So after the 9 burpees, I took a short, deep breath, picked up the bar, did a fast 6 hang cleans. Burpees were decently fast, and then 3 and 3 was a sprint. But in this gym, it is, like, incredibly, incredibly hot. Just sitting in there, you start sweating. I don't know. Today is Sunday, so tomorrow we're traveling the whole day. We won't have time to do the workouts. It is what it is for this week. Maybe once I get back, I can dial in my nutrition for the next few days. So maybe I'll feel a little better for this last week of workouts. But now, off to paddleboarding. All right, we're taking a quick detour to this farmer's market. While I'm covered in sweat from the workout, probably would have been a good idea to bring another shirt, but I mean, we were expecting to go paddleboarding after this, so I wasn't going to wear a shirt. Oh well, I'll look real sweaty. Wow. It's like a hard plasticky material. These pictures are super dope.
So two of these are from
Whoa. All these tapestries. It's like a 19-year-old college girl's dream. All those tapestries. Wow, do you want an apron, babe? You want me to get you one?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Yeah, these candles are cool.
You want a candle? Mango papaya, coconut vanilla. Also, this is my, that one's close. I like that one the most. Mara? Mara,
yeah?
Luggage, baby. You want some luggage?
No, thanks.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I think I could make that.
All right, don't ask me for anything.
For you, though.
More aprons now.
Yeah.
It's your second chance. If you want it. No, that one, that's a bib for you. That's an adult. It's an adult bib. Okay, maybe your head's too big. Your head don't fit the bib, so we can't get it. Do you want a Maui Hello Kitty coin purse?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. Do you have $5
yeah.
for it?
You're gonna have to buy it for me.
I am.
Is that beautiful?
That's cute. How much is it? $3.
$3?
I might have some quarters in the cup holder. If not, I don't know. I don't know about that. Oh, there's food. Hot dogs. Oh, here's more food. Bagels. All right, I'm getting a hot dog, but I'm getting it sauerkraut and mustard style, but I'm also adding jalapenos.
Mustard. Spicy brown, Dijon, or yellow?
Spicy brown, please. Spicy the better.
Yep.
But I forgot my card, so babe's gonna pay for me. Good thing you love me.
Okay, I don't love it when you put the camera like this to my face.
Okay. Good thing you love me. This camera's autofocus sucks. So I never really cooled down from the workout. Like, walking out of the building, I was still dripping in sweat, even though I finished the workout like 20 minutes before. And now we're in the sun, I'm still dripping sweat, so my shirt's not drying or anything. So I look like you're some unruly fit dude that's incredibly sweaty. Alright, just finished devouring my hot dog. Tessa's so having potato pancakes. You say they're not that good?
I didn't say that, I said they're good.
They're good, but your dad makes better ones? Okay.
Shout out to my dad, John.
Hey babe, you love me, right?
That much.
What'd you say?
You
said not that much?
I knew you were gonna ask for something.
Well, I mean, it's hot and I'm kind of thirsty.
We better go back in the car and get our cold water.
It's probably warm by now. I'll just die instead. That's fine. Yay! How is it?
Oh, it's sweet.
It's sweet?
Yeah, really sweet.
Do you like it?
It's good though. Yeah, the ice.
It's not that sweet.
A little bit.
It's not too bad. I've had way sweeter. It's not like it's like so sweet where it's like sour almost.
Yeah.
It's pretty good. I like it. This guy's artwork is dope. How's it going?
Yeah, Michael, come pick us up.
All we ended up buying was some hot dogs, potato cakes, and lemonade. It's usually all I ever want is food anyways. I don't need to buy any knickknacks or anything like that. Now we are trying to find a spot where we can go rent paddle boards and then walk onto the water. There's a lot of places that will like deliver them to you, which we don't need because that's more money. A lot of places that aren't close to the water, like our last one, it took a minute to walk down and that was a pain in the ass. We're trying to find one close to the water, on the water, that you can rent from. And that's different than our last one because obviously we don't want to go to the same one again. We want to try a different spot. And I'm super pumped to get in the water because it is, yeah, it only says 87 degrees, but like Hawaii heat must be like 10 times hotter than everywhere else because it is scorching hot outside. Like, I could feel like myself getting sunburnt at 87 degree weather.
We out here. We forgot our sunscreen, so we bought some like the pasty kind you rub on, and you can see where I'm all white now, and you can see where I was sunburned on my chest. But now, hopefully I can, burn the rest of the sunburn off and then get a new tan. Even though that logic doesn't make sense, but we'll see if I get any darker today. The water is definitely choppier over here versus where we were last time. So we'll see how it goes. There's some cute puppies over here playing in the water. Even though it's not that bright outside, doesn't look that hot like compared to it was like an hour or so ago, it is still burning hot and I think it has burned the bottom of my feet on the ground. They're like bright red. Holy cow, that hurt. Oh, you can't even see me because of the sand. Okay, we're out here a little bit. Tessa's playing catch up as usual, but I need to like sit down and try to adjust my oar. Is that what it's called? An oar? I don't know. But the lady that we rented this from, ooh, It was only her second day on the job, and she was like adjusting our oars and stuff. But this one feels way, way too short. Because I was told when you're standing, you're supposed to lock out your arm, and that's the height it's supposed to be. So this one's way too short. You doing good? It's a little wavier. It's not bad though. All right, I got just this paddle or oar, whatever it's called. The water is so much choppier than it was in that lagoon we were at last time, and I'm struggling super hard to stand. Tessa doesn't even trust herself. She's sitting on her board. My feet were killing me after that workout because it's all the jumping onto your toes from the hang cleans and all the jumping from the burpees. So afterward, my feet were on fire. I immediately took my shoes off. They were in so much pain. And now, again, just like last time, trying to grip onto the board with my toes so I have good like balance and coordination and I don't just like topple over. My feet are killing me. I've been out here for like 15 minutes so far. I don't know if you can tell on the GoPro though, but these houses over here are freaking huge. Like, these houses in San Diego, I'm sure, would cost several million dollars. I wonder how much they would cost out here, if it's like the same or if it's a little more expensive. But they have an amazing, like, it's literally on the water. Their backyard, they have like some patio chairs and stuff, and their backyard is the water. It's beautiful. Alright, I'm starting to lose Tessa a little too much, so I'm gonna wait for some. But here's a better look of the houses. They look ridiculous. This one in the middle looks like it's getting renovated, because I mean, it looks kind of older. But these two, one right here, and then the one right here, look unbelievable. They look like they're like at least 4 or 5 bedrooms. Probably 3,000 square feet or so, give or take. Hi, baby. I'm glad you can join me. Oh, look at my leg! Look at these houses. How much do you think these houses would cost in San Diego?
The ocean?
In general. 900?
For that house? Yeah.
In San Diego?
Okay, maybe like 800.
What? Yeah. No. That's what I'm saying. I'm saying that's cheap. 800, 800, 900, that's low for San Diego. For a big place like that? 800, 900 gets you a decently nice house. This is 1.3? I'd say closer to that. Now, how much would this house cost if it was on the water in San Diego? Like PB, North PB area? 2? Probably. That sounds about right. Yo, look at the front of my board. What's up with that? You give me a crummy one? What did someone do? Hit some coral with this thing? Yeah, someone was taking it back to the rental. They're like, man, I'm so tired. Just holding it by the fin, letting the front drag. But we're sad it's our last day in Maui. Enjoying our last day here. We're gonna have to go somewhere good for dinner. We're gonna have to go somewhere good for dinner. Yeah. Yeah. And then I'm not spending any money on you for like the next 5 months. That's okay, you don't spend any money on me either. That's fine. And I'm in the water. Yeah, I was trying to stand. It didn't work out so much. Ow! There's like a bunch of coral under my feet. Look at the nice little kayakers. Wow, over here is beautiful too. Holy, holy houses. I could definitely see myself buying a paddleboard in the very near future though, because I really enjoy it. Even if it's really tiring and really hectic. But hey, it gives me a reason to get to the water more. Maybe do some more swim workouts in the near future, open ocean swim workouts. They definitely wouldn't be very long because I don't need much to get really tired swimming, but I mean, the more I get in the water, the better. Because, you know, there's some comps that require you to do that, so we'll see. So, we went down and back that direction a little bit. We came back now to our original spot where we got into the water. And I'm impressed because even though she was standing, she didn't fall in the water. Nice job. Knock on wood. Maybe I should try to make you fall in.
No.
Okay, fine, I won't.
Focus. Focus. Oh, you're not helping. We're back out again. We just had lunch, or we didn't just have lunch. We had lunch like 3 or 4 hours ago, and then we were hanging out at the apartment, not doing much. I was on the computer, and then we kind of just laid around for a couple hours and took a nap. We were exhausted after paddleboarding. I don't know what it was. Maybe we didn't eat enough today, or?
It's just been a long week. I think we're feeling it.
Yeah, even though we didn't drink that much yesterday, probably the alcohol that didn't help out. We didn't, like, she didn't sleep that long. It's like 5 o'clock, I wake up to go pee, and then she's already on her phone, and I go back to sleep for like a few more hours. But now we're like in this little, like, downtown-y area, like, on the south end of Lahaina. Are we still in Lahaina?
Old Town Lahaina.
Old Town. Well, there you go, Old Town Lahaina. So we're gonna try to find some food. Maybe check out some of the shops over here. Ooh, Incredibles 2.
Watch when we go home.
Yeah, I really want to see that. If you guys have already seen Incredibles 2, leave a comment down below on how it was. No spoilers though, otherwise I will cry. So please make sure you don't give me any spoilers. This is like one huge tree coming across over here. It's pretty cool. Yeah, let's go walk underneath it. Sounds like we're in like a tropical rainforest.
Yeah, it does.
It's like birds chirping all over the place. But I remember last time I was in Maui, the 6 or 7 years ago, whatever, I remember seeing this tree. It's pretty cool. We drove past it earlier today when we came back from paddleboarding. Oh no, so it's not. So this is the main tree right here, but there's like different sections of trees. There's just trees over there. Is it all one piece? So it looks like this branch comes over and comes back into the ground. Yeah, so this tree branch right here comes up and around, comes into the ground, comes back over, back into the ground. So I wonder if this is one huge tree. Birds over here. People getting their pictures taken with them. Oh, I thought there was a big line. Oh, it is? Are people in line? No, everyone's just looking. Want to get your picture taken with the birds?
I don't need a bird on me.
You don't want a bird pooping on you?
I don't
need to
pay for that.
Oh. that can happen for free?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. I told you about how that happened to me when I was in 7th grade, right? It was back when I had my big curly afro.
No.
I had a big, huge curly afro. And I put like product in it, so it'd say like small, tight curls and like shiny and stuff.
Yeah.
And one day I'm walking around for PE, because for PE you had to walk around the basketball courts while you're waiting for the class to start. And then all of a sudden I feel like this wet spot on my head. And I instantly, when it happened, I like knew. I was like, oh no.
Gross.
Yeah. And I haven't grown my hair that long since.
But I think that's...
Yeah.
You should remind yourself of that.
I was scarred for life now. So babe, you'd moved to Maui?
I would.
Yeah?
Yeah, if we could find a job.
All right, let's just not get a ticket back.
Well, we already have our ticket back. We need to pack up our stuff and then stop here.
Oh. Okay.
But then by that time what happened, you can see out and...
What?
Yeah.
I mean, San Diego is pretty cool, so.
This line's long for this shaved ice.
Yeah. There was no line at the shaved ice we went to next to our apartment.
Because it was kind of bummy.
It was bummy, but I mean, it's still good shaved ice. I'm pretty sure it tastes just like all these ones do. Well, this place is popping. It's just called Cheeseburger.
Hey, Ma, do we have a place in mind?
Cheeseburger in Paradise. Oh, I mean, cool. Sounds good to me. So we put our name in, and they should give us a text at the cheeseburger place. We're gonna keep walking a little bit. But now, I'm craving ice cream.
No, it smells like ice cream so hard out here.
I'm it smells like fresh waffle cones.
That's all I want right now.
No way you can get out of smelling that and then not getting ice cream. I haven't seen calves that skinny in a long time. Boys' calves are so skinny, they look like third graders.
He's so shady.
He's never jumped a day in his life.
His feet have always, in the ground.
His feet have always been on the floor.
You jump when you walk.
Yeah, he jumps. He jumps and just gets on his toes. Here's some listings of like condos and houses around here, and this is the exact place we're staying at. And how many square feet? 435 square feet. Studio, one bath, 500,000. That's not that bad. I feel like you'd pay the same exact in San Diego for something like that.
Here's a 2-bedroom.
Is that the same spot?
Yeah.
Okay, so 2-bedroom, 2-bath, 800 square feet. That's kind of small for 2-bedroom. Right under a mill. Holy cow. 3 bedrooms, 4.5 bath, 3,200 square feet, 2.6.
You have a lot of papaya.
This looks like the place we were looking at earlier today on surf, or when we were surfboarding, when we were paddleboarding.
We got a burger, we got the California. Essentially, it's a cheeseburger with pineapple avocado and a Mai Tai. She got the barbecue burger and then a mojito.
Live entertainment. How was your burger?
It was good.
Scale 1 to 10.
Like a 6.
That's not that good.
Okay, like
what's a 10?
Oh, something amazing. Like, I'd be like, wow, this is.
But like, crazy. No, I'm like, what kind of burger have you eaten that you would call a 10?
Well, I don't know. I don't feel like I've had a 10
so
burger.
So you just have an imaginary number 10 burger in your head that would
okay,
taste.
Okay, it's like a, it was like a 7.
Okay.
It was like an 8.5.
There you go. Atmosphere.
I mean, it was cool, I think. I guess. It was cool. I guess. It was really loud in there. I feel like, you know, for some people, I'd be like, this is a cool spot. You know, there's a lot, it was loud music, it was lots going on, but for me, it was just too loud. It was hard to talk to him and.
Yeah, it was kind of
late.
Have
a conversation.
And then I'll rate the price that I paid. It was. Okie dokie. She got a, what'd you get? Mojito? I got a Mai Tai. Those were like each $9. And supposedly on their menu, they rave like it's the greatest tasting Mai Tai ever. People look like come all across the world for these Mai Tais. We had better Mai Tais at the Luau. Those things were weak. And the burgers were like $16 each. She had jalapenos added, and that was $1.50 extra. You could buy a jar of jalapenos for that much.
Yeah, but in their defense, that's what scooted the rating up from 7 to 8.5.
If the burger didn't have jalapenos, it would go down the whole 1.5 points.
I like that spicy.
Okay. Well, today was our last full day in Maui. Tomorrow we fly back. We have to drop off the car at 10. Our flight takes off at 12:45, so we have plenty of time. Because the airport isn't that big either. The airport's really tiny. So, we'll fly back tomorrow, land tomorrow night late. So, if we're leaving 12:45, that's 3:45 in California time. And it's like a 5-hour flight?
Yeah, so like we 8:45. Get in around about 9.
Yeah?
Maybe quicker with the way the sun moves.
And then,
I mean, with the wind.
And then do you go straight to work tomorrow? Or Tuesday? Mm-hmm. So, you're working tomorrow early on Tuesday. I'm working early-ish on Tuesday. Mm-hmm. So back to the normal life. This is lame. Mm-hmm. I want a vacation forever, babe.
Let's just move out here and open up a CrossFit gym.
Yeah. We'll start a GoFundMe. You guys can, you know, we just need like one, like every person give $1. We just need like 100,000 people to do that and we'll be set. And we'll just open the gym. Well, actually, it's not gonna pay for everything else too. Okay, so like 150,000 so we can, live too. We just live at the gym, I guess.
Yeah, we don't need to.
Yeah, we just won't have any morning classes. Like the first class will be like 8, so we'll be up already.
Yeah,
perfect. Fine. We already got it planned out. So we'll, you know, link down below
link down
for the
GoFundMe page.
Yeah, help us out.
Thanks.
But it was fun recording these for you guys to kind of show you the exciting things we did, all the fun stuff we had. Definitely want to come back soon. We mentioned like doing another trip sometime next year. Same deal. Unless you want to go to a different island.
We could island hop or something like that. Spend like half the time in one island, half in another, or something like that.
Yeah, we could do that. Oh, you mean like on the same trip, two islands?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Spend like 10 days here and then 5 days.
Okay. The second GoFundMe will be below to help us support pay for that. Alright guys, thank you so much for sticking along with us. If you haven't liked this video, comment your favorite pizza. Subscribe. Bye.